Hello everybody, I'm Chris and this is episode 6 of Sofia Tourist TV. Today I would like to discuss a really interesting topic about Sofia, namely the Wi-Fi in the city. That's why I have a guest, I have invited a guest today, and this is Christo Laskov. He's known, really good known in the Wi-Fi sphere or the internet sphere in Sofia, and he's going to present himself right now.
Hello, my name is Christo, and as Chris said, I'm one of the Wi-Fi liberators in Sofia. Why liberators? Because me and a couple of colleagues, and later on friends of mine, we decided to run an initiative and turn first Sofia, then maybe even Bulgaria, one of the biggest Wi-Fi hotspots with free access around Europe for the start.
So Christo isn't here anymore, but I just wanted to make sure that you know the most important part, which is there is a web page and a mobile application, and you're going to find the links of them for concerning Wi-Fi in Sofia underneath this video.
So in the end of the day, we got teamed up with one of the biggest operators here in Bulgaria, Telkom, who were really supportive, and they said, you know what, we're going to open up as much hotspots we can. And so basically what they did, they gave us in the beginning 4,000 hotspots all throughout Bulgaria.
Wow!
Imagine that. Then later on, we decided that we're going to do an even better webpage, the one that you see now. And we also created a mobile application, which is called Free Internet, and it's available on Google, Android for now.
Okay.
Yeah, you can download it free, and there you can find all 7,100 hotspots we have now currently available for access, free Wi-Fi access, some of them limited, some of them unlimited, but they're all in public spaces. You can literally go on a bench in a park or in a club, pub, whatever. You can sit down, you know, you can find the hotspot on the application. And what's the best news for you? If you download the application, it downloads the database with all 7,100 hotspots, which is actually refreshed whenever you want them to be refreshed.
Okay.
But if you download the application and you use it, even if you don't have connection at the moment, you can have the three nearest hotspots nearby you based on GPS location. You can see the address and you can ask the first passerby where is that address, and he will give you directions. In Sofia we have something like 5,000 free hotspots, free access hotspots, and actually if I have to be honest, I'm sure there are more. It's just that because, you know, we're trying to reach as many people as possible, but you know, we all got day jobs and stuff like that, and unfortunately this is a non-commercial initiative.
Yeah.
We cannot give as much time as we want to. The application itself actually allows you, it even gives you directions. If you have web connection with Google Maps, it gives you directions to the nearest hotspot to you. If you don't have internet connection at the moment, or you don't want to pay free roaming, expensive roaming charges or whatsoever, you just see the three nearest hotspots, ask for the address, and people will tell you. They're written both in Latin letters and Cyrillic letters.
Okay.
So even if you can't read Cyrillic, you can ask, you can read them in Latin, or if you don't want to read them in Latin, you can ask somebody nearby you where is that address.
A super important question then is there a Wi-Fi hotspot at the Sofia airport?
They had plans to do one, but it's not the best in the world. But you can download. I mean, it's enough to download the application.
It's enough to download, that's what I want to know. And then also at the bus and train station?
There, as much as I know, no at the moment, but I know that they are working on it.
Okay.
Yes, I also know that the Sofia municipalities have the initiative to create hotspots on the bus stops.
Oh, great.
Public transportation.
Bus stops?
Yeah.
Wow. If you, let's say, want to book your hostel,
no
or
problem,
book
no.
a ticket, so
it will take literally seconds. I mean, this is the free Wi-Fi hotspots that we have here. They are usually provided either by some ISP, either by a restaurant or a hotel, and they or a municipality or government organization.
Okay.
And they do provide good speeds.
Dear future guests of Sofia, I hope you got enough information also to make you want to come here, because as well you can use free Wi-Fi almost anywhere in the city or get really easy access. And this was for today's show. I hope this information was useful for you, and we'll see you in the next